Hey folks, Matt Sharp here with another Pacific Angler Friday Fishing Report. We are filming for 2021. January 1st, I think this will come out. Happy New Year's, everybody, and I am so excited to say goodbye to 2020. Now, I wanted to thank everybody for coming out for our Boxing Week sale. Huge success for all of you guys that waited in line for the deals. Still a few deals on, probably check in the fishing report. We might have some details on that. But also a big shout out, a big Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays to everybody that's come along for the ride. We really appreciate it. It's been such an interesting year. And my buddy was telling it best when I said I really want to kick 2020 to the curb. He said, Matt, what were your symptoms? What were your 2020 symptoms? He said, you either had the funk, the drunk, or the chunk. Well, for many of us, it might have been all three. And what do I mean by that? Well, the funk was, obviously, we don't need to talk about that. It was pretty depressing at times, pretty stressful at times. The chunk, well, I've got it for the first time in, well, 40 years, I've actually been able to put on some weight. And then the drunk, well, we all know about that. I probably can't fix that part because we are drinking beer tonight, but I might be drinking the light beer. We're gonna talk about some steelhead scouting because there is no better way to burn calories to get out there in the cold and hike around and learn new water. And then for the funk, something to bring our spirits up, we've got the best of our pictures, the stuff that our staff had. Now, I'm not talking about the biggest fish or the most epic day, but the cool fish photos from 2020 that, you know, you're gonna look back on in 5, 10 years. And so we're gonna share what we had from the staff here, and we are asking you guys to send in your pictures. I wanna see the best fishing pictures for 2020. I'll have details on what we're looking for, but there will be a prize, and we will be having those come in over the next couple weeks, so make sure you stick to the end of the report to see how you guys can enter. So it should be fun, and hopefully beat a little bit of the 2020 funk as we move into 2021. Now, I am gonna go over the fishing as well, because there has been decent steelhead reports from the Vedder, decent outlook when it came to the Boxing Day Derby. Squamish is holding, even though it's poor rain this week, and then Jay's been out a bunch of winter Chinook fishing, so I should have some pictures and some details there. As always, guys, you want to see more reports like this, consider hitting that like button, hit the subscribe button. Let's get into her. All right, guys, thanks for tuning in with me. Happy New Year. I hope you guys are celebrating in the best socially responsible ways. Big shout out to everyone. There was a whole bunch of beer dropped off at the store this season. Usually it might be a bottle of wine or a bottle of scotch, but the boys were inundated happily with beer from everybody, and I'm gonna blame it on you guys. I much appreciate it. Big shout out to the guy who brought the Yang Jin beer by. He was the first guy to say, hey Matt, I brought some beer for the report. I had this, I really liked it. I finished it before the report started. I apologize, but it was excellent. I definitely recommend it. He said it's a better beer from China. So big thumbs up and thank you for that. And thank you to all the guys that brought in beer because there was a bunch of it. But that does lead me to that chunk part where I'm putting on weight way too fast, and it's probably because of these Wednesday nights. So you might see a January sober month for Matthew where we won't be drinking beer every Wednesday. Still, again, thank you so much for all the support. Let's jump right into the weather because we've got some cool stuff to cover this week, cool stuff to cover for the new year. But first off, before we get there, weather is important, and it looks like we're gonna get utterly smoked with rain over the weekend. So it's gonna be a good couch weekend to spend if you were off because of the new year. But I kind of feel that if you guys are off Friday, if you guys are watching this, there might be a window if you don't mind getting wet. Things have been relatively cold. Even with all the rain this week, we've been watching river levels and they haven't been spiking because a lot of the rain has been snow in the upper mountains and that hasn't blown things out. For example, as we're filming Wednesday night, when we pull up to the real-time hydrometrics, the Squamish is at like a 1.8, 1.9. That's low. That's lower than I like it to fish, even though it's been pouring rain for the last handful of days. So we'll see where that goes. This guy busts through a 3, you're probably not fishing. Same thing for the Vedder. If you see it going right vertical, hold off. That said, we have heard decent reports both from the Squamish and from the Vedder Chilliwack area when it comes to steelhead up the valley and then bull trout egg eaters up the Squamish. Hasn't been banner, but pretty decent if you want to get out for a hike. If you want to fight off some of that chunk, put boots to ground, go hike your favorite stream. find as much ground as possible, because as we say, now is when the guys put in time to catch steelhead in the future, and it's actually worth it. We've been hearing much better reports in the last handful of years, at least for the early fisheries. Now, on to the fish porn stuff. And I say fish porn tongue-in-cheek, I hope there's no young ears that are offended by that. It's what we call great fishing pictures, and I think we all need it right now. And so here's the deal. I'm gonna be sharing, as we're going through this, some of our favorite pictures from this year. All the staff dumped them in, but I wanna see your guys'. You guys have supported this channel a ton this year, and we grew it from basically nothing. I think we're hovering at about 3,000 of you guys hanging out with me, drinking beer, talking fishing every week, and we wanna keep it going. So with that in mind, links down in the description, there's going to be an email there. I want you to send in your best fishing photos. The best picture voted by, well, mostly me, but the staff is going to tune in on that as well, is going to get a $100 gift certificate to the shop. There's no criteria. It just has to be fishing related and really cool. It could be funny. It could be epic. It could be the biggest fish ever. Just keep it PG-14 rated for us. Links down in the description. There's going to be an email address there to send it to, as well as some details there that you want to check out. We are going to be announcing the winner in not next fishing report, but the fishing report after that. So you got a little bit of time. If you see this about a week or two after this video is published, don't worry. Get us in those pictures. Let's see it. Let's see your best. And I'm really looking forward to seeing what you guys have done in 2020 that maybe makes 2020 not such a downer of a year. All right, guys, that's everything I've got for you. Thank you so much for 2020, even though it was tough. We really appreciate the support. I hope all of you guys have a way better 2021 than 2020. I hope the fishing pictures are even better than what we're going to see over the next week. If you guys are getting out, get out steelheading, get out egg fishing. We're gonna leave some egg fishing videos up here. We'll leave some summer run steelhead stuff, I think, down here. Good way to get yourself pumped up for winter run steelhead. And as always, you wanna see more reports like this. Make sure you're subscribed, hit that like button, and we'll catch you in 2 weeks.